Here's something I found very interesting, and I want everybody out there who grows hemp to know about that. Whitney, explain what this this is right here.
Well, a lot of people would just look at this as like a really weedy ditch, but it's something that is filled with sedges and grass and California poppies, and the daisies are done now, but this is what we would call a beetle bank. And a beetle bank is something that you want around your perimeter, running down the center of your field somewhere, because in this sort of crazy mess of grass and sedge and sunflowers and things like that live the predatory insects that we all want. We want those insects to be alive and well, because in the evenings they fly out there and eat all the insects that could do damage to your crop. So the predatory beetles and the insects that live in these sedges go out and feed at night. If you have a healthy beetle bank, you shouldn't have an unhealthy insect problem in your field, because they regulate for you. So this is a natural area, it's a natural biome, and it helps you have a better crop and not have to use any sorts of...
Name some of the plants that would make
A beetle bank. The family of plants that really attract predatory insects are sedges, grasses, sunflowers, daisies, any sort of large, clumpy, dense, grasses, sedges, sunflowers, off the top of my head, those are the things that I tend to plant. And then the sunflowers are also, you know, you're also feeding a lot of birds.
So this beetle bank protects this field of hemp by housing the beetles that come at night and eat all the bad guys that are going to bother your crop.
That's exactly right. Isn't that neat?
That is very cool. Thank you.